I'm Pastor George Borghardt, and this is another Higher Things video short. Was Jesus immersed at his baptism? And does it matter? That's the subject of today's Higher Things video short. Like, subscribe, ring the bell, get the app, share, donate. If you love what we're doing in Higher Things, pass it on the faith to the next generation. Like our videos, subscribe to our YouTube channel, ring the bell for notifications, get our app. It's available on all major platforms. Share our content, spread the word. Sharing is caring. And donate. A tax-deductible gift to Higher Things keeps us passing on the faith to the next generation, keeps us rolling. So, one of the main things that opponents of baptism by sprinkling use is the baptism of Jesus. They say Jesus was dunked, and so that's the way it has to be. Now, there's a couple of things I want to take a look at. I want to take a look at the text, but I also want to sort of think a little bit about this. So first, let's look at the text. This is verse 16 of chapter 3 of Matthew. And when Jesus was baptized, immediately when he came up from the water, and behold, the heavens opened, and a voice from heaven said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I'm well pleased." Now, first, the idea. Now, was he dunked? Well, initial read sounds like he was dunked, and that may be true, or it may not be. The construction here, Jesus apo tu udatos, with anabe being the verb. Now, anabe means to come up. Apo tu udatos means from the water. Now, it could mean that Jesus came up from the water, like he was submerged and he came up from the water, and that would be fine. It also could mean when he came up from the water, it means simply that he was kneeling in the water and the water was poured on him. And after the water was poured on him, he came up from the water. Both of those are supportable in Greek. So either works. So the answer to was Jesus submerged could be, possibly, sounds like it, maybe, but not necessarily. The second thing is the scriptures are descriptive of what happens and what is to happen in the life of the church, not prescriptive always of what must happen. What I mean by that is we are witness to a couple of events in the scriptures. One, Jesus' baptism. Two, the institution of the Lord's Supper. Those are descriptions of what happened. We see it. Not prescriptions of what we must do. Okay? So to celebrate the Lord's Supper, we do not have to recline at table with our disciples like Jesus did. We simply take bread, give thanks, break it, and give it to the disciples. Same with the cup. A baptism includes the Lord's words, "I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit," Matthew 28. And water. That's what's important. The fact that Jesus may or may not have been submerged, while interesting, isn't necessarily required. If we make it required, we make the whole thing a work we do that by getting it right, doing it the right way, is the only way it works. Now, that is not particularly Christian. That's actually more Roman Catholic, where the priest has to do the thing in a certain way or it doesn't work. Christians, and Catholics are Christians too, but the main deal for Christians is that the Lord's words and water are there. The words of St. Augustine, "Accidit verbum et elementum fit sacramentum est." The word combined with an element makes the sacrament. Or better, there's water and the Lord's words. There's bread and wine and the Lord's words. That's what's important. And so whether there is an immersion or a sprinkling is not important as whether there is water and the Lord's words. If you get wrapped up in how much water there is, or how the water is being sort of dealt with in the baptism, you're sort of losing the focus on what's the important thing, that the Lord is putting his name on you and that he's delivering his promise to you. So was Jesus baptized by submersion? Sounds like it, but not necessarily. Does that matter? Not generally. What's most important is that we have water in the Lord's name. That's the big deal. Water in the Lord's name, then you're born with the Spirit. Water in the Lord's name, you're saved in holy baptism, 1 Peter 3. Water in the Lord's name is that your sins are washed away. That's Acts 2. So the big deal is not whether or not you're immersed or not. It's whether you're baptized or not, because baptism delivers Jesus and all that he did for you. Questions you want to argue with me? Go ahead. Make them in the description. Make them in the comments, and I'll love to bounce back and forth with you on this, because for me, the important thing is that you believe that Jesus died and rose again for you. Not how that happens, but that faith grasps hold of that word in the water. I'm Pastor George Borghardt, and this has been another Higher Things video short.